Hey guys, hope you're all doing good. For the last 2 months, I have been working on my new game. I initially made the prototype version of the game for Brackey's Jam 2020.2 in the month of August 2020. And the game was called Rage Recorder. As the name suggests, this game is for a section of people who really have a thing for games that really makes them suffer. And when it comes to platformers, these kinds of games are called precision platformers. And this game is exactly for this section of people. I initially had doubts regarding picking up this game and all that, but interestingly, it made 32nd place in the fun category. So I was like, why not? So the concept of the game is simple. You live in a tape recorder world where you can collect items that can rewind, pause, or fast forward certain elements in the game. The goal is to platform your way through the level and reach the endpoint. The main focus being how accurate your movement and jumps are rather than the puzzle element itself, in order to get a more dynamic playstyle. My current plan is to expand this idea, add more variations to it, and make it a complete game in the end. There is a bit of a twist though. In the past, I attempted to play a few precision platformers, but I instantly dropped them because I couldn't get used to the controls and the general difficulty in general. But now, I guess I will have to pick them up and complete them in order to even make a precision platformer by myself. Well, since I was a little serious this time, it wasn't that hard actually. I completed Celeste and proceeded to the End is Nigh, and even though the games were tough, the experience was worth it. With my newfound confidence, I was finally ready. Or that's what I thought. I wanted to make a lot of levels out of my own imagination, but I could hardly make around 9 to 10 levels. You see, I'm sort of a perfectionist. It sounds like I'm bragging here, but it's not exactly a good thing. In my mind, I always have this compulsion to make everything from scratch, and sometimes it just doesn't happen. So I had to throw away my ego and go watch some tutorials on game and level designing. I studied how other platformers are made and got some insight on how to make mine. So the theme I ended up with is, each level is gonna have a set of sections and each section takes up the whole screen at a time. So the player has to solve section by section. Also, the levels teach the player a specific rhythm in order to solve a section. And this is also made harder as levels progress. Few levels break the rhythm too, so that the game doesn't feel very one-dimensional. I'm keeping the tape recorder mechanics intact, but I will add more variations to it to keep things fresh. Now, in order to get a good platforming experience, I used a platforming code from Sebastian Lake's platformer series. This gave me a lot of control in the jumps, movement, and a lot of freedom to fine-tune the experience. It's also a good base to implement any new mechanics. And I don't think a traditional rigid body approach will give me this level of flexibility. For level designing, I use the inbuilt tile system in Unity. It's very quick, easy to use, and it's also good for quick prototyping. At this point of time, I have completed designing the levels for the first phase of the game, and I'm satisfied with the current results. Next, I think I'm going to work on making some art for this phase, and it is a good switch from all the programming I have been doing for so long. And I forgot to mention, for the last 2 months I had no idea what I should call my game. After countless hours of searching in internet and rejecting everything, I finally decided on Sunshine After Rain. I really like this name and it has a bit of a poetic feel to it. I don't want to spoil the story of the game, but here's a bit of an obvious spoiler. The name is linked to the story of the game. And there you have it, folks. That concludes my first devlog of Sunshine After Rain. Anyways, I'm planning on making a devlog once every 2 weeks. And if you want to follow my progress even more closely, follow me on Twitter. It will help me stay motivated to make this game. If you like the video, don't forget to subscribe to the channel. I promise I will upload more frequently. With that note, thank you for watching. See you in the next video.